Hey guys, what is going on? My name is TOgoesIn, and I have a short little, I done messed up, guys. I done goofed super hard. So I just got done recording. Let me see how long I actually recorded for. So I got 32 minutes of footage right here, sitting on my little editor program. And, so I live streamed last night, and I used the same program to live stream and to record. And last night, I ended off live stream with muting my mic on XSplit and playing some music. And I hopped on this morning. Usually I don't record this early in the morning, and this is probably why. But I hopped on this morning, and I recorded 32 minutes of footage. I put it in my editing program, and there is absolutely no audio from me. So there's 32 minutes of awesome footage that I am going to edit down, put music behind, and speed up, so that you guys can hopefully still kind of get an idea of what was going on, because as you guys see behind me, I captured this area. There's a hidden chest. I've got this freaking wand of negation, some golden nuggets. I'm pissed off, man. I done goofed so hard, and hopefully I can try to redeem it with these upcoming clips of sped up footage. I hope you guys enjoy the music. RX came out with a new song. That'll definitely be in there. And yeah, so hopefully we'll pop back in with a little bit of an understanding of what you guys missed out on. And yeah, hopefully this works out. right. Well, I just got done speeding up everything, and I put the music behind it, and it actually looks like it is pretty freaking sexy, in my opinion. So I'm gonna recap. So basically, we started off this episode with I'm actually gonna go back to the village. 1 second. Alright, so basically we started off the episode by giving a little tour of the village, since it has grown since episode 1, which is what I'm gonna go and do right now. But I just wanted to do a little recap. So I went to the village, I found another village, a Norman village off to the east over there. I found some diamonds. I got a diamond sword and a diamond axe. I tried to do the freaking frustrated lumberjack mission, and he still doesn't want to accept my diamond axe, so I'm kind of stuck on that one. The Norman village. I also found this little dude who wanted to buy wine, but I didn't have any to sell him. I collected some chickens. I almost starved to death. And that's about it. Oh, and I tried to... I've been trying to trade with the Mayans enough so that I can get a freaking house, but they don't like me. I don't know why. I don't know what to do about it, but hopefully eventually they'll learn to love the frog, or else I'll kill you, you freaking stupid Mayans. God dang it. All right, well, we are back at the Mayan village after, so much good footage was lost, man. I was doing so boss. All right, so we've got ourselves a couple new buildings. This one he actually built last time. Oh, I don't think he's done building it yet. Is he done building it yet? Oh my goodness, I've actually never seen a house like this before. Alright, so Mr. Builder Man just built this house, and I have no idea what it's about. Let's check it out. Yeah. Akaks McCon, yeah. I think this might just be like a little house for living and stuff. Oh, then you got your upgraded stone mine. He upgraded this with cobblestone. This was actually upgraded with cobblestone. If you guys remember, the roof of this was all wood and there was grass. Oh my goodness. Oh, this is new. So there was grass over here on this, and now looks like he is making himself a ball court right now. Because the Mayans, if you guys have ever watched the movie El Dorado, if you haven't, you definitely should. It's a freaking great movie. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry. Please don't hurt me. So there is a Mayan game that is played sometimes to the death, if I'm correct, where you have a little ball, and it's kind of like soccer and basketball mixed together, where you have to kick it around, you hit it with your elbows and your head, you can't pick it up and throw it, but you have to get it in between these rings, and then I think the first person to get you a certain amount of points wins, and then the other team is slaughtered mercilessly in front of their families. So it's all fun and games. So you got this was upgraded as well. It looks as though this was also upgraded. This is a little house. I don't know if this was here before in episode 1, but I definitely know that these two buildings weren't. So this is a little house, and this is a little stone mine. So the village is coming along quite nicely, but unfortunately I still cannot buy a house, which is quite stupid. And unfortunately the weather is crawling up my butthole. My goodness. Clear. Oh wait, I gotta do weather clear, huh? Weather clear. Nobody likes you, rain! Nobody likes you! You're just a distraction. What the heck? Get out of my face. And the sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar tomorrow. So, since an entire episode's worth of footage is basically lost, I'm probably gonna go head over to the Norman village and show you guys that real quick, because it is quite handy dandy. Oh my goodness. Actually, I want to check out what this does. So this was I found this in a little secret chest that was hidden in the ground over there. So something that I've learned just from playing Minecraft, if you see cracked stone, if you're playing a mod and you find yourself a structure and you see cracked stone brick, such as this, dig there. There will probably, hopefully, if the mod is cool, if the modder knows what's up, there is probably treasure behind it, and it is worth breaking and checking out. So I did that, and I found myself a chest, and it had 14 gold, 16 maize, a wand of negation, and some moolah. So we're going to go and actually, oh my goodness, we are probably going to be able to buy a house now. Hello, friend. Hello. Will you buy my gold? Buy my gold. Buy it! Yeah! Yeah, alright, where's your king at? I got a lot of meat off of that. Let's see if this guy will sell me a freaking house now. I just gave your town like 14 gold, bro. Buy me a house. What the heck? I want a house! God freaking dang it. What the heck? God, poop. You suck. You guys suck. I'm gonna go over to the Norman village. You guys are lame. I'm leaving you. I'm gonna go hang out with Normans. Yeah. Yeah, Normans are cool. Alright, so we're gonna head over here. The Norman village is 458 meters to the west. Oh yeah, we're actually gonna be killing all the white sheep we can as well, because we can sell that shit. So we will be back with Normans in our face in 3, 2, 1. Alright, well, we are right outside the Norman village. It is right behind those trees right here. And I'm actually gonna gather up some wood because I would like to help the Norman village to grow. So, there are a couple different cultures. There's the Hindi culture, there's the Mayan culture, the Japanese culture, the Norman culture, and I think there might be one more. I think that might be it. I think there's just four. But every culture has some specializations. Once you grow the village enough, once the village has developed, once enough buildings have come in, once there's a high enough population, certain buildings will be allowed to be built, such as the armory, the blacksmith, things like that will be added into the village. And so each, what am I trying to say? Each village has its own special items. Actually, if I show you, I'll just show you right now. We'll go to game mode one. We will go over to here. So, if you look at this, there are obviously plenty of items that have been added in by the mod. And all of them are fairly unique to the culture they come from. So, what this is Ikiyaki. Obviously, you will find this in the Japanese village. You will find the Byzantine boots in a corresponding village as well. And then you got your obsidian axe, which I'm pretty sure is from the Mayans. And then if you come up here, you get your Norman broadsword and your Norman armor, which is honestly what I'm going for right now, is to get some of that going. So I want to grow this village in order to get some Norman armor, some Norman broadsword, some Norman tools, because I've heard they are pretty freaking boss-tastic. And so we are going to have to freaking stay the night here, I guess. Okay, I need some cobblestone. I need some cobblestone. I'm going to go get some cobblestone, and I am going to see you guys in the morning. So, yeah, see you guys in the morning. And once again, typical Kermit the Frog has turned getting a simple task such as getting iron into such a freaking difficult thing. I've got to make some more iron. I got to get another iron pickaxe. I might as well. I'm just grabbing all the iron I see, because I'm pretty sure I can sell it to the Normans and for a decent amount of price. Hopefully I will rise in the ranks faster than I did the Mayans, because I don't know what's up with them. They just don't like me. I don't know why. But we are going to wait for this iron to smelt, make a new pickaxe. I'm pretty sure it's still nighttime. So many things to do in so little time. Oh my god, there's coal. I could have used that instead of the wood. Freaking Kermit is a noob. Oh my goodness. Oh. Looks like we found ourselves a ravine. Hello, friend. Hello. Do you want to play patty cake? Patty cake, patty cake. Bake me a cake. Blow up now or die, you stupid fuck. Oh my goodness. Alright, well, we'll just leave him there. Oh my lord. We might be able to find some more diamonds down here. I wonder. Alright, we've got ourselves a new pickaxe. Alright, so we are still on the obsidian gathering freaking mission. We actually have no space in our inventory. Let's drop that and that. We don't need that. Or string or gunpowder at the moment. We have like 4 bows in our inventory. What the heck is going on? Swords, my goodness. My goodness. Alright, let's make ourselves this. Alright, well, we are back in business. Hopefully we will pop back up in the daytime with enough resources to help them out with their building project thing. Alright, well, we don't see any diamonds, but we sure do see some gold. We are going to... Holy moly, that thunder is loud. We're just going to hop down here. Whee! Get this gold. Hopefully there is a little bit of more gold. Holy moly, that thunder is freaking... I don't even know how deep I am. I am almost down at the bottom of the world. And I can freaking hear Freaking thunder. Do I have a bucket? I do not. Whatever. We're going down, guys. We're going down. I can see clearly now. The rain has gone. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba. All right. Well, we are up here. We are ready to do some business. Let's see. You still need some cobblestone. Yes, you do. There you go, friend. Of all the cobblestone you could ever want. And all of my wool. I don't need that. You can have a bow. Oh my god, I can trade them bows? Nice. Nice. I can trade them a whole bunch of crap. Might as well give them all of our jungle wood. Oh my goodness, they have glass for sale. I definitely did not sell them that. Alright. Okay, what else do you need? That's it. I think that's it. Alright, I would like to take a moment and take in this map of the village so far, because it is definitely going to grow into something very, very majestic and very, very large. So hopefully, there is another page. Alright, purple is construction in progress, blue is other buildings, green is suitable building areas. Light, oh my goodness. Oh, that is, light green is suitable building areas, but cannot contain the center of the building. Dangerous areas, lava, cactus, etc. Now we're all good. Alright, well that's pretty sweet. Okay, I'm gonna sell you. I don't know if I should sell you my wood or not. Oh, I will sell you a bunch of that. Okay, let's go find your king. Is this your king? I'm a regular visitor. I'm already a regular visitor here. Oh, I need a cider. Alright, I can get you some cider, I think. I cannot. Never mind. I don't know how to do that yet. Alright, I would really actually like... Come on, I wanna be your friends! I just want a freaking house to live in! Meh. Let's go see if we can find ourselves like a quest to do. I think that's a builder. This will be a stone mine, it looks like. Look, watch him go. Go, little man, go, yeah. Look at you placing down a little mine. This doesn't look very miney. Hey, what's up? What's up with you? Nothing? Alright, well, I think my time here has been spent. Hello, horsey. Ooh, I can get a horse. Off to chat, building. There's nothing to do, you stupid Normans. Why can't you develop faster? Alright, well, I've got a decent amount of gold that I would actually like to, we can figure out what this does now. We can figure, oh my gosh, actually, no, I know what I'm going to do. Alright, so, trading can go both ways. I'm going to buy some stuff and see if that increases my, like, dude, I'm gonna buy some stuff in the Mayan village. That's where I want to be king, personally. That's just where I fit in. Where I want to be. I'm a Mayan at heart, guys. I'm a Mayan at heart. And I got maize in my hand. What's up? My maze, yeah. Alright, we are back in the Mayan village. And holy moly. Oh, no. What do you mean, not enough space? Oh, no. No. There is not enough space, guys. Oh, crap. I don't know. Oh, what? Come on, don't stop growing. Well, this, oh man, that's gonna freak me out. All right, well, this has definitely been upgraded. They've got some smooth stone now going on down here. And let's see. Freaking weather is pissing me off again. What do you know? Everybody's off to sleep. Oh, crap. I don't know if that, oh no. There's different upgrades and stuff. Oh my goodness. All right, well, I'm gonna go reside to my bed and maybe figure out what this does, because I wanna know what that does. All right, we are back at my house. It is now the next morning. I just went to sleep. And let's press M and see if we can figure out what this wand of negation does. So we are, oh my Goodness, creating or destroying a village. All right, spawning villages. You can spawn a village type of your choice to the location of your choice with a summoning mon, an object that you can buy in any village whenever you have enough. Whenever you have a sufficiently high reputation to use the wand, put a gold block where you want to spawn a village. Alright, destruction of a village or a lone building. The inhabitants of a village or building respawn every night. Even if you destroy all the buildings of the village to prevent this, if you want to occupy the buildings yourself, for example, you must use the wand of negation. You will find it in the chest of the main building once all the inhabitants are dead. Holy shit, this is depressing. Please note that the destruction of a village is irreversible. It is possible to create a village with you as the leader in which you can pick the location of the buildings. To do this, you need to either be recognized as a leader of the culture of the village or to have completed the creation quest. Alright, so we officially have the power to just wipe out an entire village if we want to, which is kind of tripping me out because I'm feeling a little murderous. I'm feeling a little murderous right now. Yeah. I'm trying to... Should I destroy the village, guys? I don't know. It's really tempting. I really just want to give it a go and see what happens. It could just become like a giant desert town or a deserted ghost town kind of thing. Or, I don't know. I could get rid of all the buildings. Who freaking knows, man? There's only one way to find out! There is only one way to find out, guys. And we will probably do that in episode 3, but it is up to you guys. Definitely leave a like and a favorite and a comment if you guys enjoyed the episode. I'm thinking about going off and creating a new village somewhere else, or focusing on the normal village. I'm kind of scared. I'm gonna fly around. I'm kind of scared that this village won't be able to grow because of how widespread it is and how little land there is. Because there's like large bodies of water. God damn it. Gosh dang it. Alright, well hopefully by tomorrow I will be able to tell you guys whether or not this village should be deserted or not. And I might fly away to a new land and start myself a new village. But until then, we will stick around and see what upgrades I can do to the buildings. That'll be fun. I would still like to become a king. I'd still like them to build me a house, but if they don't have any space, then there's not much I can do. Other than give you guys a sexy-ass outro. Hey guys, my name is Grimblin Minecraft.